In the chapel of Our Lady Undercroft at Canterbury, the late Archbishop lies in state. At the funeral on the following day, the Archbishop of York says the prayers.
Enter not into judgment with thy servant, O Lord. Grant unto him eternal rest. We believe verily to see the goodness of the Lord. O Lord, hear our prayer.
The Dean of Canterbury receives from the chaplain the late Archbishop's pastoral staff, which had lain on the catafalque, and takes it to the high altar. To his right, at the top of the steps, is Archbishop Lord Lang of Lambeth, predecessor of Dr. Temple, whose 80th birthday coincided with this solemn day. It is only 2.5 years since Dr. Temple was translated from York and enthroned as 96th Archbishop of Canterbury and Primate of all England. During that short time, he has proved himself to be a truly great leader of the Church, and his name is honored by men and women, young and old, in all walks of life. So, on the shoulders of 8 sergeant majors and staff sergeants of the Buffs, the coffin is borne in procession from the high altar steps, through the screen, to the west door of the cathedral. The procession included the archdeacons and bishops of the diocese and clerical and lay officers of the province. And now the last rites are complete, except for the private committal in Cloister Garth and the requiem for the repose of the soul of the Archbishop, sung in the cathedral on All Souls' Day.